It's the NFL playoffs on EA Sports. No bigger stage than this one. Sold out MetLife Stadium, located just outside of New York City. Ahead, we'll decide the second entrant to next week's NFC title game, as we've got a great one in store between the New Orleans Saints and the New York Giants. The fourth and final ticket to the conference championship round. We'll know soon enough as we are right here on a January afternoon. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Begin on the ground with Kamara. It's a wonder, and he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Touchdown, New Orleans. They talked about stringing together some explosive plays here in the playoffs. That was a pretty explosive play.
It certainly was, and if you're going to win on the road, it certainly helps to have big playability in your hip pocket, doesn't it?
Lutz with the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. Kadarius Toney gonna elect to bring this one out. And not a good return here at all, as they'll be forced to start at the 12-yard line. Jones and the Giants now with a first and 10 at their own 12-yard line. They'll start out on the ground at Saquon Barkley. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line. That one 28 yards on the ground.
You know, I have a pretty good friend, Charles Davis, who tells me that when he sees plays like that, strong runs to the right, reminds him of the 1960s Green Bay Packers.
Boy, those were the days back when the fullback actually carried the ball as well as blocked. Then you had a halfback. You had pulling guards, guys who could get out and run. And you can hear the great coach saying it back then. So we get a seal here and a seal here, and we run this play right in the alley.
So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. Now Jones. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Malik Hooker. And he'll take this all the way down inside the 40.
Well, it's a cold night, and whether you're a quarterback that wears a glove on his throwing hand or not, that ball is a rock, Brandon. You've got to really drive it through the cold and the wind, or it can take off on you, and that may have been what happened there.
Following the interception, Winston. That would complete downfield to Thomas. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. Oh, they're going to run a little pop pass here. And he'll score. Touchdown, New Orleans. Michael Thomas from 4 yards out. And the Saints are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Lutz good on the extra point, and it's now 14-0. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. Fielded just outside the goal line.
And good coverage there on special teams as he'll get him down shy of the 20. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And they're in an early hole. The first drive, they threw the interception. That led to a touchdown, so decent-sized deficit early on.
It is, but I think you hit the key words, early on. So they have to decide, do we even need to change game plan, or do we just need to execute better and try and get back in this game?
36 yards on the play.
I don't think anyone would argue that having that extra week definitely helps come playoff time. And those were some fresh legs right there. That extra practice time and planning, certainly in evidence.
A first down carry for Barkley. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. Well, you're down early. How do you get back in the game, maybe establish the run? I think they're trying to do that.
Now I'm with you on that one, and what I like about the message is that there's no panic from the head coach. He's already told his offense coordinator, let's run the football, let's get things settled down a little bit and find our way back into this game.
He'll take a shot for the end zone. And he's got it. Touchdown, Giants. Kadarius Toney, 36 yards. And the Giants are back within a score. The fly route works for the TD grab.
And you know what the receivers love to say? If we get even with the defender, we're leaving. And that's exactly what he did, all the way into the end zone. And then he was on the business end catch once he got over the stripe.
Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And not a good return here at all as they'll be forced to start at the 12-yard line. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
Give them a couple on the carry there. Second and eight. Hill with a give to Kamara on the option. Give him three on the run there. Now they're looking at a third and about five. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Jameis to throw it. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Kayvon Thibodeau. And he'll bring it back to about the 5-yard line. Really nice pick there for the reigning NFC Defensive Player of the Week. And a good story on that, he said he didn't even know he won the award. His buddy had to call him. He saw him on television and said, hey, congratulations. How about that?
And I'll bet you his buddy said, well, since you didn't know, I'll just go ahead and claim the award, right? And everything that goes along with it. But the reason he won the award the previous week and what we just saw there, instincts. Understanding where the play is going and being able to make a play on the football.
They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. In trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
Second down and goal. Jones, back of the end zone. Could he get his feet down? No, it's incomplete.
Those throwing windows get a lot tighter near the end zone, don't they? And here's the thing. You already probably have 3 points in your hip pocket. You force a throw here and give up an interception, you come away with nothing.
Especially tough in the middle third of the field where he threw that one. Now, they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. Jones out to the flat, that's caught. And that is caught. He's got it for a Giant touchdown. Darius Slayton. A 5-yard touchdown, and the Giants have come back to make it a 2-point game. Jones throwing for it, And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
I don't know about you, but I can't wait for a few years of two-point tries and see what the data tells us, because a lot of teams want to throw the ball in this situation, this time unsuccessfully. I just wonder if maybe running the ball might be the way to go.
With it moved up from the three to the two, you would think maybe a few more attempts at running.
I think stats over time may bear out that running the ball will at least be the equal of throwing it in that situation.
Now a timeout here, at least for the moment. Hey. Looks like one of the Saints is injured, shaken up on that last play. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. They start the drive on the ground, Kamara. And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
They have three tight ends in that formation. That's almost a universal sign that they're planning to run the football. But how about the defense there? They met force with force and caused a stack up behind the line of scrimmage and threw him for a loss.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. They run it again with Kamara. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 89 yards for him on the ground so far. A great start to this divisional round contest. One thing's for sure, this defense has to figure out how to stop the ground game. He's eating him up here in the first quarter.
It looks like they have to go to different forces, aren't they? The conventional things aren't working too well. So I remember a coach of mine saying way back when a back's having a great game, you've got to get the ball out of his hands. See how far he can run without the ball. And what he meant was takeaways, knock it loose, because maybe you can't just stop him with just regular tackling.
And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And this is going to hit the goal line and continue on into the end zone for a touchback. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that. In Charles's defense, they were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated. They both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
After the incompletion, they'll try once more from the 20-yard line on second and 10. Jones with a handoff to Barkley. And he'll get only a couple up to the 22.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
Throwing, Jones. Gets this out to Saquon Barkley. And he's going to be taken down about a yard shy of the first at the 29. That'll go for a gain of 7. And that's going to make it fourth down.
Well, it looks like they got what they wanted. They got the completion, but they weren't able to break any tackles or gain nearly enough yardage to pick up the first down. Now to be fourth and short.
An entertaining start to this one. More to come on EA Sports. On fourth down, here's Jamie Gillen on to punt. Deonte Hardy deep for New Orleans. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And the Saints will take over with a first down and 10. Ready. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And Charles, a very uninspired effort. The last time we saw them out there was a quick three and out, then they punted the
ball. You never want to get stopped so soundly during a series, but what would be even worse now is letting it happen again right here. They've got to get going.
But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground,
honed in on it, and stopped him. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher. Third down and 9. They'll come to the line here needing 9 yards to pick up the first. Off the play fake, Winston. He's going to float this one deep right side. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
Oh, I thought he had that one, and that was nearly a big third down conversion to give this drive some life. Instead, they're on the spot and help separate the receiver from the ball.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. A big kick there. We'll call it 56 yards on the punt. And it'll be Giant football first and 10. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. Over on the sideline, hoping to hit that reset button between possessions. Last time out, they had to punt it away. This time, hoping to finish this thing off in the end zone. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Now, that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick, more than a space eater. He just made a great play there.
Here's Tony on the quick slam. Every lineman knows the rule. You only get a 1 yard buffer beyond that line of scrimmage, and then the flag is thrown, and he got tagged. Jones fakes the give to Barkley. And he's taken down here by the Saints. Marcus Davenport. Credit him with a sack, and it goes as a loss of 6.
Well, that's what they have to do more of defensively. Not just getting sacks, but they have to keep getting in his face. Not let him get his feet set and deliver. He's been carving them up previously.
Yeah, already has a couple of touchdown passes. About time they put a few grass stains on that jersey. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. He'll get this out to Barkley complete. And he's not going to sniff the first down here. He stopped at the 25.
We can make this one pretty simple. Locked up all of his progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back. But how about the way they ran to the football and knocked him down to force a fourth down?
On to punt, Jamie Gillen. On the return, Hardy. So a change of possession here on the punt. And out will come the offense as they take over. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Again, it's Kamara. And some space here. Touchdown, New Orleans. Alvin Kamara with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Saints are able to strike quickly here as they are in for 6. Lutz with the extra point, and that makes this a 9-point game. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. Taking it about the 1. And he's going to be out of bounds here as the run back will leave him shy of the 20-yard line. Thank you. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalposts, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least two first downs, because even if you have to punt then, you change the field position, right? You flip the field a little bit. They didn't get that done. This time they want to string together a nice drive and help themselves out.
Multiple defenders getting to him there for a huge loss.
Now that was a passer's nightmare. The front totally shut down by the defense, so he kept going backwards, hoping to find another avenue of escape. It didn't exist.
After the sack, oh, they're staring at a challenge basically from the other side of town. It's second and a country mile. Back to throw. Jones. And just not enough on the throw there. Down around his feet and incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Looking to throw. Jones. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
This defense has certainly played well so far in this game, and the coverage has been tight on just about every throw. Forced a few here so far in this game. And now it brings up fourth down.
Jamie Gillen now on to punt. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Here's Hardy set to return. So a good punt there, but a very strong 14-yard return. And they will take over first and 10. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started.
As the offense begins another drive here, pretty simple, Charles. They want to carbon copy what happened the last time out when they ended their drive in the end zone.
You're right about that, partner. Sounds pretty simple, doesn't it? Just score again. We know it's not that simple, because we don't just make adjustments at halftime if you're a good football team. You spend that time on the sideline, you study what's on the notes and the tablets, and you make those adjustments to prevent a repeat of the last drive. Series to series, the best teams, that's how they get it done.
And we'll find out here soon enough whether those adjustments are enough defensively. A throw over the middle, taken in. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. That's a gain of 31 with right around 1 minute to go in the quarter. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Here's Kamara off the draw. And some room to maneuver. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Alvin Kamara saving his best for the playoffs with his third touchdown of the game. And the Saints will extend their lead in the final minute of the half. Lutz good on the extra point. And that could be important, as that makes this a 16-point lead. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. Well, not much time remains here in this first half. We'll see if they can get something out of this drive, at least a field goal. They could certainly use it, down by two scores. They go play action here on first down. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They're giving him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
To throw once more on second and 10. Jones. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
They have to like what they've done defensively here at the outset of this drive. They forced a couple of incomplete passes, bring up a third and 10. Don't be surprised to bring a little pressure on this snap.
Here's Jones to throw on third down. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all, and I understand why. They look lethargic, out of sync, and it shows on the scoreboard.
And here's Gillen on now to punt as he gets this one away. And this will be taken at the 13. They'll call that a punt of 59 yards. Tough to do better than that. And there'll be time for maybe one final play before halftime. Final play of the half here, Winston. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Partner, what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
They'll throw now on the final play. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. So we've come upon halftime here in this NFC Divisional Round matchup as we get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. A trip to the NFC title game hanging in the balance. Second half action back underway. And we will not see a return to start the half as this will be a touchback. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And Charles, that had to be an interesting locker room at halftime. This is a team that's had so much success this year. Haven't really had to deal with a lot of adversity at halftime, to be honest. But now here they are with their playoff lives on the line.
And I think when you're alluding to that interesting locker room, you're just wondering, how are they handling that bit of adversity that they're seeing right now? Because I think this is a team that has to look to lean on the veterans at this point. We know we're better than this. We've proved it all season. Let them disseminate that confidence through the locker room. But this opening drive, it'll be an important one for them to give them a little jolt of confidence moving forward.
These guys have punted four times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. Back to throw, Jones. He rifles one that's intercepted. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick. Tough one there. First drive of the third quarter, throw an interception, and now a chance that they could be an even a bigger hole if they can convert this into points.
Yeah, but how good do you feel if you're that defensive coordinator right now? Because you just know that the head coach looked at him and said, turn him loose, big man. And he'd be able to take a few extra chances playing with this type of a lead, and boy, it paid off.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3 yard gain.
3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other three here on third down?
Well, praise has to go to the guys on the offensive line because they've had a very nice, productive day running the football. How about that poor defensive line? They've been knocked around the entire game, and while they slowed them down on that run, can they continue to do so? Because they haven't had much success throughout this ball game.
Here's Kamara trying to run for it. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. Winston to the sideline here on fourth down. And Will Lutz gets set for a New Orleans field goal try. The kick by Lutz is good. So after four touchdowns in the game for this offense, this time they're forced into taking the three.
But you did mention four touchdowns, right? So four out of five, not too bad. I think that's a pretty good record for them.
Following the made field goal, Lutz to kick it away. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive.
I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
Now a play fake here on first down. To Barkley on the check down. All that for a 2-yard gain, second down.
And that's why you do all the drills that you do from the quarterback position, because you're not going to just throw to your strength. The right-handed quarterback naturally will want to move to the right side to throw the football. But sometimes you've got to go left, and that's exactly what happened on that play. Forced to his left, still able to accurately throw it downfield for a completion.
He'll rifle this one deep right side. And he will take it on in for a Giant touchdown. Well, if they're going to make a game of this in the second half, they need a few big plays to go their way. That's one.
And the way to get it done is to also conserve time. So to your point, that big play right there, now you're not moving the ball downfield, taking time off the clock. You're leaving yourself a better avenue to continue to try and make a comeback.
Two-point conversion caught in the end zone, and that cuts the lead a bit further. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Cost him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. Their lead down to 2 scores after the touchdown a moment ago as they start with a 1st and 10. And for one of the first times all night, he is going to go nowhere as they bury him behind the line. And that's going to go as a loss of 6, and it'll set him back for 2nd down. The busy night continues for Kamara. And he'll be taken down, but they've got this one up to the 35-yard line.
Man, 222 yards for him on the ground now. He has been a tough man to bring down all night.
So after the run by Kamara, now another 1st and 10. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry.
And space tough to come by there as he'll get maybe a yard to the 37.
Well, it's hard to have vision as a runner and find a hole when there's nothing but defenders in your way. They stacked that one up really well. But give him credit. Instead of trying to bounce it out and turn it into a big play, which might have turned into a big loss, Kai just took his medicine there and took the 1 yard.
They'll try to throw now. Winston. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be 3rd down.
There is something to a game plan with trying to keep a defense honest with a guy with that type of speed. You do so. Send him deep. Try to throw some air under it and hope you connect downfield. On that play, they were unsuccessful.
On 3rd down, Winston.
gets to his running back. It's Alvin Kamara. And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
This offensive game plan has just been sensational. I mean, when you think about all the different ways they've gotten their receivers open so far, it's really been impressive. Scheme, design, execution.
Now a first down carry. It's Kamara. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through, but that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
One quarter remains for a trip to the NFC title game. Second and 11. Now here's a little touch pass as they tap it quickly to their receiver.
And good penetration here. He'll get this down only to about the 49-yard line.
That's a nice job there defensively, being able to diagnose that little touch pass. They saw it coming, converged on it before he could get much out of it.
The Saints on third down, just 1 for 5 to this point. This is third and 10. Winston. And intercepted, maybe the turning point. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line. A few things better than a big man interception. You can always tell right when they get the football, there's that level of excitement and nervousness and also like, what the heck do I do with this thing?
And you say, no better sight? Well, not for the quarterback who just threw it. It's bad enough to throw a pick, but throw one to the big guy? But you're right about that. Now what do I do with it? But what's fun about it is, you know they're going to be in the film room after this ball game telling all their teammates, maybe I should shift over to offense. I've got skills. What do you think?
Oh, absolutely. I always find myself cheering for them after they intercepted. Unfortunately here, he couldn't make it into the end zone.
He started out having some troubles back in the first half connecting with his receivers. Really hasn't gotten a whole lot better.
Yeah, he's at less than 50%, and you and I both know that just won't do. So I would think about spreading things out, putting it on the receivers, make them win those one-on-one battles on the perimeter and find their way open.
That'll be caught. It's Tony. And they move this all the way down to the 9. Give him 30 yards there.
The dynamic duo is doing damage in this one, and they've certainly been on point throughout, and they hook up again for another big play.
They'll try and run for it with Barkley. And he'll take this from the 9 down to about the 7.
Not a whole lot there on first and goal, and that's what you're looking for defensively. You'll certainly live with giving up just a yard or two in this situation.
The line of scrimmage, the 7 now on second and goal. Toward the pylon, caught. Touchdown. Kadarius Toney saving his best for the playoffs with his third touchdown of the game. And the Giants have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth.
Had the option to hand that one off or run it himself, but instead, a really easy, quick pass.
I like the way they made a decisive decision and got it right to the receiver. One move later, he's in the end zone.
And he will get into the end zone as a two-point conversion is successful. And the lead is down to a field goal here in the fourth.
Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And this has been a tight game to this point. Of course, they usually are at this juncture of the playoffs. But with the lead and the football, the clock right now, their friend, as they try to book their spot in the conference championship next Sunday. Run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. Now Winston. Incomplete. Took a shot.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go three and out here and give the football right back, because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
Now Winston. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, but it's good for a first down as well. Big hookup there, forced to throw it on third down. The connection's going to keep the drive alive and also keep the clock moving.
Yeah, and from a defensive perspective, didn't get a sack, didn't knock the ball free, didn't break up the pass. The clock keeps running on you. You're in a dire situation now.
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down, second and right at a yard. And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you?
Touchdown, New Orleans! When you talk about the dominating rushing performances that you and I have seen together, this has got to be right up there. His fourth touchdown run of the game and another long one to boot.
And I don't need to ask for a witness, because you're right here with me. We are watching this, and we're watching such a performance that is demoralizing for anyone on defense. You know, it starts out, coaches screaming, tackle him, get him. And after that last touchdown, I'll bet it's pure silence on that side of the ball.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And this could be the defining moment of their season, all hyperbole aside. You're trailing here in the fourth quarter, the divisional round. They need to come up with something as they get this drive started. Tyrann Mathieu there to make the tackle. Maybe I'm wrong, but it looked like even if he had opted to keep that, I don't think there was going to be much to gain.
Seemed like it was perfectly defense. And know what they say, those guys on the other side, they get paid too.
Throwing on second down, Jones. He's got a man complete. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. A gain there of 30 big ones. So the big play moves him all the way across midfield. It's first and 10 from the 45. He's going to go up top again. And that's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete.
Partner, they've been aggressive airing it out all game long, and no better evidence than those last two snaps. They weren't going to beat this coverage, though, two plays in a row, and that one falls incomplete.
Out of the shotgun, they run with Barkley. And good space to operate there as he takes this down inside the 35-yard line. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Off play action, Jones. That's complete to the tight end, Akins. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. Two minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Giants football here as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. The play fake, Jones.
This will be caught at about the 6. And the Giants are going to be set up with a first and goal on a pass play that moves them all the way down to the 1. Jones.
And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Shaquem Griffin, he was relentless there as he hits home for the sack.
That I'm struggling to understand a little bit. That close to the goal line, first down, run the football. If you want to throw it, throw some play action on second down.
Here's Jones.
This is caught. I give him a dozen on the pitch and catch, but now they're up against a 3rd and goal. And he takes this one into the end zone, and all of a sudden, here in the final minute, things get a little bit tighter.
I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They got the touchdown they needed. But if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively, though, you're probably hoping for a 1-5 play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right. And if you have that 1-5 play drive, you actually build up momentum and even more hope. When they had to slog their way downfield, they got the touchdown, but it's almost like,
yeah,
you know.
Doesn't feel right.
Exactly.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And this game not quite in hand yet. We'll likely see all 3 timeouts defensively and then reassess where we are. Uses the stiff arm and able to set his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. The Giants going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this 4th quarter. Another yard would probably put this thing in the books. It's 2nd and 1. They'll pound it up the middle with Kamara. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. It's a gain of 4, and that should just about seal the deal.
They're probably about 1 big play from getting into field goal range. I'd go with a 2-deep coverage, make sure my safeties are back to cover all of the field deep.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. And they're moving on to the conference championship. How about this?
What a tremendous feeling to get to the game that can get you to the Super Bowl. A fantastic season. Unfortunately, for the other team, a tough, tough way for it to end.